we're going to move on to reviewing the European fixtures first. We'll start with Young Boys Rangers. James Tavernier, I think, has been widely scapegoated for this. He tried to half the invisible man in the final minute, and it cost Rangers a vital point and arguably cost them 3 points. 2-1 to Young Boys. It opens that group up. Do you think, first of all, do you think Tavernier's been harshly scapegoated?
Oh, absolutely.
And do you think Rangers need more bottle for moments like that?
The bottle one's a hard one. Tavernier first is that, yes, he got it badly, badly wrong. But I don't think anybody would disagree that had Tavernier not had the couple of moments, that Rangers would have come away with at least a point. But that doesn't excuse half of the stuff he's had in social media. By all means, people can criticise a guy. I'm not saying no to criticise a guy, because it's what we're here to do. Football fans, by their very nature, are going to be critical of stuff. If you lose a game in the 93rd out of 95 minutes, of course people are going to be pissed off, and of course people are going to be angry. But there's a way to do it, and a way to conduct yourself just as much as fans expect players to conduct themselves a particular way. So yeah, I do think that Tavernier has been harshly scapegoated in that way. He's not the first player to make a mistake. He'll not be the last player to make a mistake. And believe me, I've watched far better players in a Rangers jersey than James Tavernier make a big mess here. And it's football. That's life, mate. Get on with it.
I think it's some of the stuff afterwards, calling them for. You see it surface every time last year. Literally every single time Rangers drop points or something didn't go to plan, it would
be. He's not a captain.
He's not a captain. He's never a captain. He can never do that. But there's very little of that when, you know, he's getting a hat trick of assists in a game, or, you know, scoring the second minute in the Old Firm and all that sort of stuff. And I just think it was really poor in parts. And it cringes, I cringe looking at some of the stuff, because he's given a lot to the team. I think over the last couple of years, and you could say that in certain games he carries the attacking threat despite being the right back. And it was two awful errors, and you're sitting there seething watching it, because it's I think, you know, the word schoolboy comes up all the time, and literally that's what it was. It was really, really, it was tough to watch, because it wasn't even as if the first one you clear your lines, you know, you get rid of the ball, and the second time you just don't lunge at it with your wrong leg. It was really, really bad, and it cost us on the night. But there needs to be a sense of perspective, I think, with it as well. So the group is wide open, as you say. Every team is on 3 points. Yes, we should have got at least something from the game, but and it was his mistake. Like, if he doesn't do those things, as you say, we probably would have taken at least a point from the game. But he has also won us a lot of games, given us comfortable margins in games. And I think in general, when you have someone like Steven Gerrard, who was a fantastic captain during his time, he's picked him out. He's Gerrard's man, and he's come out and defended him after that and said how great he is in the changing room. Boys like Borna Barisic, who's captained by Luka Modric at international level, comes out and says he's brilliant for me, he's helped me, and everyone clearly really respects him at the club. And I think sometimes fans, just because he's not some big Graeme Souness type figure, fans don't accept the fact that he should be. They say he's not, you know, worthy of the armband. But I think in general he's brilliant. He's not been quite as good this year as last year, but some of the stuff was very, very over the top.
The thing is, the stuff with the captaincy is just ridiculous. I've seen people going about how, he's obviously not a leader. It should be someone like McGregor or Stephen Davis. See if McGregor or Stephen Davis did a silly wee strip of fabric on their arm to try and get their teammates to be doing better and to do whatever else. And they're no leaders to start with. They're no the right pick for captain if they need to have that wee bit of fabric. And same for James Tavernier, that taking that off him is not going to make him any much better or worse of a player. All right, it might take some of the responsibility off him, but when you look at what the guy actually contributes to the side, what the hell are people expecting? He scored 17 times last season.
16 penalties or something.
I couldn't care less. See, when you look at all great goals, when you never ever go, they scored X goals, but so many were penalties.
So some Celtic player just scores own goals.
And still love
him. And still love him. I think one positive.
Can't wait, he scores a hat trick against you.
Yeah, that one happened. You get big Declan Gallagher at the back.
KV Scotland.
First ever
call up social media has had for a player.
No, that was Lauren Shanklin.
Steve Clark's just picking players off of Twitter now.
One thing I think from the Young Boys game that was evidently clear in a positive light for Rangers was how good Morelos was. Now, for me, he is the best informed player in Scotland.
There we go. Sense prevails again.
I mean, he's absolutely ragdolling elite European centre-backs. And he is on a run of form which he might not reach. He's playing at a level that he will struggle to maintain throughout his career.
I actually thought he was far better against Feyenoord. His goal against Young Boys was brilliant, but I thought that there was long spells when he struggled to get into the game, not through anything his own doing, but just because passes are breaking down and just the game is just one of those scrappy, scruffy, everything gets kind of caught up in midfield. The guy runs himself into the ground, but I really do think that his performance in the Feyenoord game was probably the best I've seen from him in a Rangers jersey since he's come to the club. I thought it was unplayable.
Yeah, I mean, any team that loses to, you know, a team with Sadie Anko in it deserves criticism, in my opinion.